Good evening, everyone. Thank you for joining in. We do appreciate you joining us once again. We love you and appreciate you, and thank you so much for being faithful to join us each week. And we do look forward to when we are able to get back together and worship God together. But it is neat that we can worship God wherever, whenever. And so we do love you and appreciate you, and we are praying for you. And if you do need us, please don't hesitate to call. Love to help you out any way that we possibly can. But may God continue to bless you and take care of you and keep you safe and healthy. But as we mentioned earlier, don't forget, if you would like a Stand Firm or Journey devotional, they will be ready to be picked up by next Thursday. Again, thank you so much for joining in, and may God bless you. Let's pray. Dear God, thank you so much for who you are and what you do. Lord, thank you for your grace and your goodness and your mercy and forgiveness. Thank you for your unconditional love. Lord, thank you for always being with us. And Lord, once again, we pray, Lord, that you will minister to each one in a special way. Continue to provide for them and take care of them and keep them safe and healthy and help them always know that you are with them every second of every day. Lord, I pray, Lord, that they will experience your peace and your joy. And I just pray, Lord, that you will continue to do your great and mighty work in their lives and in their midst, Father. Please take care of them. And Lord, I pray, Lord, that as we continue to go through this time of uncertainty, that you will just keep our focus on you, and that you will just continue to teach us and use us as you wish during this time. Help us be a light for you. And again, thank you for each one, and please bless them. In Jesus' name, amen.
Good evening. Thank you so much for joining us again tonight. As parents, we know that there are many things that our children do that bring great joy to our heart. And as children of the Lord, there are things that we can do that please God, that bring joy to His heart. And one of those things is worshiping Him. And so we're going to sing a song, Blessed Be the Name of the Lord. And let's just sing to touch His heart and to bless Him and to worship Him tonight as we gather again online to worship.
Blessed be the name of the Lord, the glories of my God and King. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name, blessed be the name, blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name, blessed be the name. Blessed be the name of the Lord. He breaks the power of canceled sin. He breaks the power of canceled sin. Blessed be the name of the Lord. His blood can make the foulest clean. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name. Blessed be the name, blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name, blessed be the name, blessed be the name of the Lord. I never shall forget that day. I never shall forget that day. Blessed be the name of the Lord. When Jesus washed my sins away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name. Blessed be the name. Blessed be the name. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name. Blessed be the name. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Many of you may remember about a year ago, we had the Alabama Singing Men that came and were in concert in our church, and we had a wonderful congregation that night, a great group of people, and I'm a member of that group, and one of the things that we do at every concert is at the end of each concert, we come around the congregation, and we sing the very simple chorus, "In my life, Lord, be glorified." And I want to invite you to sing that with us. Many of you will remember that song or know it from other ways, but I want to invite you and let it be your prayer, "In my life, Lord, be glorified." So thankful for our staff and staff families that have made these services possible. I'm thankful for Irwin and Miss Gail that have played the piano, and so thankful for Tanya and Miranda and Callie that have sung during this time. And Miss Tanya is going to come and share a song with us tonight for our special music.
School, I memorized the golden rule and how Jesus came to set the sinner free. I know the story inside out. I can tell you all about the path that led him up to Calvary. But ask me why he loves me, and I don't know what to say. But I'll never be the same, because he changed my life when he became everything to me. He's more than a story, more than words on a page of history. Ground beneath my feet, he's He's everything to me. Living in uncertain times, and more I find that I'm aware of just how fragile life can be. I want to tell the world I've found a love that turned my life around. They need to know that they can taste and see. Now every day I'm praying just to give my heart away. I want to live for Jesus so that someone else might see that He is everything to me. More than a story, more than words on a page of history. He's the air that I breathe, water I thirst for, and the ground beneath my feet. He's
Amen. Thank you, Miss Tanya. And I want to thank everybody who has made these services possible, folks coming up and playing music and singing, and just want to say thank you. If you have your Bibles with you this evening, I want you to turn to the 23rd Psalm, and then I want you to turn to Matthew chapter 7. I know that's kind of an unusual combination, but I think you'll see it when you get to both of those passages. We're thinking together tonight about paths of righteousness, plural, paths of righteousness. So if you have your Bible, Psalm 23, I really want us to focus on verse 3 of Psalm 23. It says, "He restores my soul, He leads me in the paths of righteousness for His name's sake." Now, that's what Psalm 23:3 says. All right, get this in your mind and mill it over for just a minute. One road, many pathways. One road, many pathways. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I don't want you to misunderstand where I'm headed with this at all. There is only one way to salvation, and that's by faith in Jesus Christ. He is the way, the truth, and the life. No man comes to the Father except through Him. So with that in mind, He leads me in the paths, plural,
plural of righteousness for his name's sake. Now I want to read to you Matthew chapter 7, verse 13. The Bible says, "Wide is the gate and broad is the way that leads to destruction." That's perhaps one of the most rehearsed biblical cautions that you'll ever hear. Wide is the gate and broad is the way that leads to destruction. But that passage goes on to say, "But narrow is the gate and difficult is the way which leads to life, and there are few who find it." Now I want you to just imagine for just a minute that you had to walk across Dothan. That's a long walk, by the way. I wouldn't want to do that. But just imagine that on your walk that you had to be confined to a narrow path. Can you imagine that? Man, I can't imagine that. It's almost impossible to keep your footing on a narrow path. In addition to walking through Dothan on a narrow path, I want you to know that the gate is straight. Now, what the Bible means when it says the gate is straight, it doesn't mean that there are no curves. It means that the way is difficult, okay? Extremely difficult, all right? So the path that leads to life is extremely difficult to navigate. It is narrow. It is potentially winding. And if that's not bad enough, the Bible says there are few who find it. That's what Matthew 7:13, that's the way it finishes. And there are few who find it. So here we are. We've been going through the book of Psalms. We've been really focusing on the 23rd Psalm. Last Sunday night we were in Psalm 46. And tonight we're back in Psalm 23, but just for 1 week. And we've been thinking about the fact that we are sheep. We're like lost sheep, and we're aimlessly wandering on a very tedious, long, narrow, winding, obscure road of life. Now, you want to talk about a dire strait, we're in it. And were it not for the Good Shepherd, we would never, ever find our way in life. But thanks be to God for the Good Shepherd who leads us. Not only does the Shepherd know the way, he is the way. Now, sometimes in our wandering, that leads us into enemy entrapments. Sometimes our wandering allows the enemy to follow us so closely that he knows where we live and how to gain access to what should be our safety zones. But that's where the Good Shepherd comes in. The Shepherd will lead his sheep and guide them down the paths of righteousness where we can find rest and water and safety. And although the ultimate destination, green pastures, is the same for all of us, we're all looking and longing for heaven, the ultimate destination. The paths that safely lead us to this destination can vary based upon the scope of our wandering. So what I want us to do, we're really going to focus on Psalm 23:3, and I want you to think about this phrase, "He leads me in paths of righteousness for his name's sake." We're going to kind of break that phrase down. Number one, we're talking about his paths. He leads me, look at verse 3, in the paths of righteousness. Now think about this. From the north, the south, the east, and the west, God is bringing people to himself. The Bible says in Psalm 107, verse 3, "And gathered out of the lands from the east and the west, from the north and the south." Folks, we may come from different places, but God has redeemed us through the work of his Son on the cross, and he's redeemed us from the hand of the enemy. And so no matter what your background may be, I want you to know that God can reach down, he can redeem you, and he can place you on the path, the paths of righteousness. The Bible indicates that he brings people from secret places. Psalm 27:5, "For in the time of trouble he shall hide me in his pavilion. In the secret place of his tabernacle he shall hide me. He shall set me high upon a rock." I want you to know we celebrate a great God, and He has placed us on the paths of righteousness. And I want you to be assured that if you've put your faith and trust in Jesus, that if you've called on His name for salvation, that He has you on the path that leads to everlasting life. So I want you to think about that. Number one, His paths. But I also want you to think about His leading. He leads me. Man, isn't that a great thought, to know that God will lead you? Listen, if you'll just give attention to God's Word. Man, God is still speaking. He speaks every day. The problem is that you and I just don't always listen. Let me give you some indications of God's leading. Think about this. He is a lamp to our feet. The Bible says, "Your word is a lamp to my feet and a light unto my path." Psalm 119:11 says, "Your word have I hidden in my heart that I may not sin against you." Ladies and gentlemen, if you'll allow God to speak to you through His Word, He will provide, He will be a lamp to your feet. But I want you to know He will lead you to the green pastures as well. Psalm 65:11 says, "You crown the year with your goodness, and your paths drip with abundance. They drop on the pastures of the wilderness, and the hills rejoice on every side. The pastures are clothed with flocks. The valleys are also covered with grain. They shout for joy. They also sing." God leads us. He is a lamp unto our feet, and He's leading us to green pastures. He's also, Psalm 23 indicates this, that He leads us beside the still waters. Now, I want to read to you from the book of Revelation. Revelation chapter 7, verse 17, the Bible says, "For the Lamb who is in the midst of the throne will shepherd them." Isn't that a great thought? Man, we're talking about the Good Shepherd in Psalm 23. In Revelation 7, it talks about the Lamb of God, and He will shepherd them and lead them to living fountains of waters. And the Bible says in that verse, "And God will wipe away every tear from their eyes." Ladies and gentlemen, we have a God who doesn't just save us and secure us. He continues to lead us and guide us. So, number one, His paths. Number two, His leading. And number three, His reputation. Now, if you look back to Psalm 23:3, "He leads me in the paths of righteousness." And think about this phrase, "for His name's sake." That's talking about His reputation. When we think about our Good Shepherd, we need to think about who He is. Well, the Bible says that the Lord is a strong tower. In Psalm 91:2, "I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress, my God, and in Him will I trust." Man, there's been so much uncertainty these days with the coronavirus and all the things that are going on surrounding that. Isn't it good to know that our God is a strong tower? He's our helper, and in Him we will trust. But not only is He a strong tower, the Lord is my defense. In Psalm 46:1, we talked about this verse last week. It's a great verse. "God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble." The Lord is a strong tower. He is our defense, and He is our light and salvation. Psalm 27:1 says, "The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear?" The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? Ladies and gentlemen, you don't have to live in fear. Man, there are so many things about COVID-19 I have no idea about. But I promise you, when I go to bed at night, I don't lay in bed and worry about it, because I'm in the hands of Almighty God. Nobody and nothing can remove me from His hands. His hands are strong hands. They are powerful hands. And He's got us. He's got it. We just need to look to Him, His reputation. We think about His paths, His leading, and His reputation. Now, I want you to know that we can't make this journey by ourselves. The road is too rough, the night is too dark, and the enemy is too fierce. But we have a Good Shepherd who is more than able to keep us from faltering. And he will do so because we are ambassadors for him. And his reputation and glory are at stake. And he deserves all the glory due his name. Man, when you look at this passage and you think about the fact that we have a good shepherd, that he is leading us to the paths of righteousness for his name's sake, I hope that that brings you comfort. I hope that that brings you peace. And I hope that it brings you joy. Pray with me if you would. Father, thank you that you are God who is very much concerned about your children, the lives that we live, the problems that we face. So, Father, we just look to you for leadership. We look to you for direction. God, we express our trust in you, and we thank you that you are a good shepherd. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you so much for joining us tonight. If you need to speak with me or a member of the staff or one of our deacons, please feel free to call us. We look forward to seeing you back at Bay Springs very soon.